Fluocinonide is a high-potency corticosteroid commonly used topically for a number of inflammatory skin conditions. In this video, let's find found. What is fluocinonide? What is fluocinonide used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking fluocinonide? How does fluocinonide work? How to use fluocinonide? What is fluocinonide? Fluocinonide is a potent glucocorticoid used topically as an anti-inflammatory agent for the treatment of skin disorders such as eczema and seborrheic dermatitis. It relieves itching, redness, dryness, crusting, scaling, inflammation, and discomfort. A common potential adverse effect is skin atrophy. In 2020, it was the 280th most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 1 million prescriptions. What is fluocinonide used for? A topical anti-inflammatory product for the relief of the inflammatory and pruritic manifestations of corticosteroid-responsive dermatoses. Contraindication. Underlying infection, fungal, viral, tubercular skin lesions, or herpes simplex. Hypersensitivity. Ophthalmic use. Side effects. Acne or pimples. Burning and itching of the skin with pinhead-sized red blisters. Burning, itching, and pain in hairy areas, or pus at the root of the hair. Increased hair growth on the forehead, back, arms, and legs. Lightening of normal skin color. Lightening of treated areas of dark skin. Pharmacodynamic. Fluocinonide is a potent glucocorticoid steroid used topically as anti-inflammatory agent for the treatment of skin disorders such as eczema. It mediates its effects to relieve itching, redness, dryness, crusting, scaling, inflammation, and discomfort associated with inflammatory skin conditions. Mechanism of action. Fluocinonide is a potent glucocorticoid steroid used topically as anti-inflammatory agent for the treatment of skin disorders such as eczema. Fluocinonide binds to the cytosolic glucocorticoid receptor. After binding the receptor, the newly formed receptor ligand complex translocates itself into the cell nucleus, where it binds to many glucocorticoid response elements, GRE, in the promoter region of the target genes. The DNA-bound receptor then interacts with basic transcription factors, causing the increase in expression of specific target genes. The anti-inflammatory actions of corticosteroids are to involve lipocortins, phospholipase A2 inhibitory proteins, which, through inhibition of arachidonic acid, control the biosynthesis of prostaglandins and leukotrienes. Specifically, glucocorticoids induce lipocortin 1, annexin 1, synthesis, which then binds to cell membranes, preventing the phospholipase A2 coming into contact with its substrate arachidonic acid. This leads to diminished eicosanoid production. Cyclooxygenase, both COX-1 and COX-2, expression is also suppressed, potentiating the effect. In other words, the two main products in inflammation, prostaglandins and leukotrienes, are inhibited by the action of glucocorticoids. Glucocorticoids also stimulate the lipocortin 1 escaping to the extracellular space, where it binds to the leukocyte membrane receptors and inhibits various inflammatory events, epithelial adhesion, emigration, chemotaxis, phagocytosis, respiratory burst, release of various inflammatory mediators, lysosomal enzymes, cytokines, tissue plasminogen activator, chemokines, etc., from neutrophils, macrophages, and mastocytes. Additionally, the immune system is suppressed by corticosteroids due to a decrease in the function of the lymphatic system, a reduction in immunoglobulin and complement concentrations, the precipitation of lymphocytopenia, and interference with antigen-antibody binding. Like other glucocorticoid agents, fluocinolone acetonide acts as a physiological antagonist to insulin by decreasing glycogenesis, formation of glycogen. It also promotes the breakdown of lipolysis and proteins, leading to the mobilization of extrahepatic amino acids and ketone bodies. This leads to increased circulating glucose concentrations in the blood. There is also decreased glycogen formation in the liver. Dose. Corticosteroid-responsive dermatoses. Apply thin layer, topically Q-day or Q12-HR, to affected areas. Psoriasis. Apply thin layer topically Q-day or Q12-HR to affected areas. Atopic dermatitis. Apply thin layer topically Q-day to affected areas. Safety advice. U.S. FDA pregnancy category C. Animal reproduction studies have shown an adverse effect on the fetus, and there are no adequate and well-controlled studies in humans, but potential benefits may warrant use of the drug in pregnant women despite potential risks. That's all the information about fluocinonide we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.